in her concert, she was sort of still regarded as a very, very big star because she had just done the Carnegie Hall comeback tour. So she wanted to jump into television because it was the one area of her career that she hadn't really succeeded in or dabbled in. She'd only been on television maybe four or five times before in specials.
He said Lucy would cringe because she never thought of herself as a star.
You made me love you. I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. You made me love you. And all the time you knew it. I guess you always knew it.
Hey, I met Steve in 1978 when he was just getting out of college.
We were writing partners. We wrote two books together, The Dick Van Dyke Show and The Lawrence Welk Show. But I always thought of him as my little brother.
But I met his mom in the early 80s, right before her marriage to Dick O'Malley in 1984. After Steve came out of the closet to his mom later in life, thinking that he had pulled the wool over her eyes all those years, I asked her if she ever had any idea that he was gay, and she said, well, I had my suspicions when he was collecting Judy Garland albums when he was in high school. So I guess she really wasn't fooled. They weren't very close in terms of seeing each other when he lived in L.A., but he did go back to be with her in her final days and were very close when she passed.
I will miss his sense of humor, and I will always miss him.
Steve's arrival in West Hollywood was an event, and I was his roommate. Our friendship was immediate, and he helped me enjoy life a lot more. He'd have Judy Garland TV show viewing parties at our place, introducing me to many dedicated fans she had then and still has. He moved back to Chicago to complete the Dick Van Dyke Show book with Jenny, but returned to Los Angeles to be head writer for my TV series, Crisis Counselor. Later, when he was having a difficult time deciding what book to do next, I suggested he write about what he loves, Judy. But he felt that writers like John Tricke had done it all. And later he proved otherwise with Rainbow's End. I valued his talent, but more his ongoing friendship and advice. He became part of my LA family, and it will be a part of me for the rest of my life.
He liked to show up at dinner. He would call, always nearby, just minutes away, and say, what's for dinner? And sometimes he just stayed over for days. We make our own families in this world. And Steve was my brother. I think that's what's most special about Steve and what we're all gonna remember about him, that there he was whenever you were doing something or working on something creative and you needed that push and you needed someone to critique it, but always he was there as a supporter and your biggest fan. And I'm gonna miss that.
Smile, though your heart is aching.
Smile. Judy loved Barbara. She was one of her earliest champions. And Judy loved new talent. And the ratings when the show premiered were quite good. She was opposite Bonanza, which was then the second top-rated show on the air. The last 5 years of her life after the series did show a decline in her health. Liza said to me, she said that the series is really the closest that anybody could come to knowing Judy without knowing her.
My first telephone conversation with Steve lasted something near 2 hours. We never drew breath. And that pretty much continued the pattern for the 35 years I knew him. What I will remember most about Steve is his devotion to his work, his devotion to his abilities, his devotion to his mom, his devotion to his friends, his devotion to Judy.
There's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby.
Steve's most outstanding trait would have been his capacity for friendship. The only other thing I could say to him is thank you for the friendship, for the memories, for the ongoing and the shared joy and the laughter and the compassion.
Why, oh, why can't
Richard and I met Steve in June of 2008 at the Judy Festival in Grand Rapids.
It's all so peaceful on the other side.
What I remember most about Steve is his enthusiasm and his generosity. When I read Rainbow's End, I was blown away. He called me wifey, and he was my other husband. Like everyone else, I loved him.
Oh, that's life. That's what people say. Riding high in April, shot down in May.
He listened to this particular song each day to get his energy going. I first met Steve in September 2002, and I remember when I walked into the room, I saw Steve Sanders, and I was thrilled because I was such a big fan of his Rainbow's End book, but at the same time, I was scared to death to talk to him because he was a celebrity to me. So when I finally did get the chance to talk to him that night, it was great because he just made me feel so comfortable and so relaxed. When I moved to Chicago, that's when our friendship really, you know, blossomed more. Steve was funny, smart, handsome, charming, the most talented writer I ever knew, and a wonderful friend. I'm grateful that I was a part of his life.
She loves me. We're as happy as two can be.
Steve was a great professional partner, and we spent hours together on the phone every day discussing every morsel, whatever new fact we unearthed. It was great. It was a great experience. Steve was made a big difference in my life.
Please welcome Tom Gilbert and Steve Sanders. How nice to have both of you all here. Surprised you the most?
Desi was so talented creatively and was so good for her, and that Lucy was so remote and closed off and not close to people, including her children. She wasn't warm.
Lucy Arnaz told us that when they were married, Desi wouldn't allow Lucy to do talk shows because he said the world did not want to see the real Lucille Ball. They wanted the image of Lucy Ricardo.
You know, Steve was always there to, you know, A, build me up, support me, B, point out how ridiculous the situation was. And he was able to see other people's situations with great clarity, but could not see his own with great clarity. And that is, you know, the big irony of it all. He was a loyal and supportive friend, and I'll always miss him.
What'll I do when you are far away and I am blue? What'll I do? What'll I do when I am wandering high? Feel just now, what'll I do? What'll I do with just a photograph to tell my troubles to? When I'm alone with only dreams of you that won't come true, what'll I do?